everyone, welcome to another Make a Card Monday video. Before this video gets started, I want to let you know that there will be no videos next week, starting on Monday. There will be no Make a Card Monday or Friday Focus. That's because I'm going out of town. I'm going to be on vacation. Yay! Warmer climate, beaches, it's going to be lovely. So I'll have today's video and then I'll have a video on Friday. But then after that, I'll, you know, won't be really online much for a whole week. So anyway, today I'm going to be making a card sketchbook. I've done this sketchbook a couple times in the past, but decided I needed a new one, especially since I was mostly drawing my sketches on, like, scratch paper. So I'm going to go ahead and make my little booklet template again. I have the free PDF that this file is available at my blog. You can go over there. It's absolutely free. I'll have a link to it in today's blog post, as well as I'll link to the previous versions of the sketchbook as well, so you can see other examples. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut off, it says down here, cut it this line and then fold in half horizontally. So I'm going to do that. Forgot to mention, I did print these double-sided. So I ran it through my printer once and then flipped it over and ran it through again. You might want to do it just one time just to test it to make sure you have your paper in correctly, if you're not familiar with printing double-sided on your printer at home. But after that, once you know that it's right, go ahead and just print out as many sheets as you'd like. I'm doing 5 sheets. It is folded in half, so it's going to be a thicker 10-sheet book, but I don't want it too thick because, you know, there's a lot of spaces for card sketches anyway. I'm going to go ahead and trim this down. I just trimmed them all at once. If you're not completely on that little dashed line, don't worry, because we're going to fold it in half and then trim it so it lines up nice, so no worries. So I'm going to take each one and fold it in half. And I'm doing this because I don't want to fold them individually because it might be a little bit too thick. I think I've folded them together in the past, and it was okay, but I'm just trying to simplify things a little bit. Okay, so now I'm going to put them all together. In fact, if you wanted to, you could alternate them, which I think I will. I'm going to alternate them. Okay. So you see how these edges don't line up now? That's because it's folded pretty thickly on one side. So I'm going to get my paper ready that I'm going to have be the cover of the book. I've chosen this paper. This is from Prima, and it's from this 12x12 pad. I've used it a couple times in the past. It has 48 sheets of pattern paper. You get 4 of each design, so you get a ton. And they're all ledger patterns, so they're really great basics. So I don't know if you can see this. They have one that are more Christmas themed. Just a really good variety. And they have 2 different pads. They have this one, which is, I think it's just the original, and there's one that's labeled 2. And there's 48 different sheets in that one as well. So it's a really good value. All the pattern paper I'm using today is from that same sheet. So I cut this to 8.5, and I'm going to have this be the front because I really wanted to have the flowers in that bottom corner. So I'm going to go ahead and, let's see, this is, it's about 7.5, so I'm going to cut this to 7.5 and then fold it in half. I'm going to get this all in here just right. Now I'm going to use my pivot point stapler from Close to My Heart. If you don't have a pivot point stapler like this, you just open up your folded book, like over a seat cushion or a mouse pad, something that's going to have cushion on the bottom. And then you open up your stapler so it's really wide, and then you staple it like this. The prongs will stay open and you just bend them over yourself. But since I do have this pivot point stapler, I'm going to go ahead and use it. And it's great because I can come in here and get right on that fold. Sometimes I don't get it right on the fold, but that's okay. We're in luck pretty much on the fold today. Rare. Okay. So these books tend to be really thick and they don't ever want to actually stay closed. So after I have mine decorated today, I'm going to like put it in a big dictionary or just a really thick book to flatten it out. Okay, so now I'm going to take my T-square ruler and an X-Acto knife, and I'm going to even up this edge here. And I'm going to press down really lightly. I'm going to take these off one paper at a time. Okay, I think I got everything. All right, so now I have a really clean edge. If your top or if your side edges don't match up, you could do the same. Mine are pretty even, so I'm just going to leave them the way they are. All right, I'm taking another pattern paper from that 12 by 12 pad. This one is actually, you know, winter or holiday-esque, but I'm just going to use a small portion, and I thought those greens matched really well. The letter stickers I'm using are from American Crafts. These are the Eric foam letter stickers. I'm going to cut this off about at this line right here. I'm going to round both of these corners with my We Are Memory Keepers corner chomper. I'm going to use the half inch. Oh, and that really doesn't want to work, does it? Temporary. I think I'll probably have to do the same over here. Yep. Okay, put that back on. Take this one off. Taking some craft cardstock and a 1-inch circle punch. And with my white gel pen, I'm going to write card and then do some dashed lines around the edges. While that dries, I'm going to put adhesive on the back of this. All right, I'm just going to put some dimensional adhesive on the back of the circle. Put that right there. All right, I'm going to punch a scallop edge for the right bottom there. I'm just going to use a whole sheet of craft and then trim it down. Alright, I'm going to put some Tombow Mono Multi-Glue right along this edge. And put that down. I'm going to kind of squish it so it really moves to the edge. Alright, and I'll do the dashed lines along that edge to make it kind of match with that circle. Alright, and now I have a card sketchbook with all those predetermined portrait cards and landscape cards with the right sizes. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys on Friday for another Friday Focus video. Thanks for watching.